So we welcome you here, and we give you our greetings from we, the tangata whenua of the Waitaha people, Ngāti Moamoe people, and Ngaitaha people.
There it goes.
And then I put my hand to the mountain and prayed for the salmon. We're here for these salmon. Let them make their way back home.
Take a pinch of this and I want you to pray. This is going to be full of salmon someday. All the way up, they're going to be full of salmon. The Lindada Nor, the old time salmon. Our salmon that are in New Zealand are so very important to the life of the tribe. It has to happen. The fish have to come back. These fish have to swim home. And until we get our eggs back from New Zealand and the fish are swimming up here, it's the only way they can be recovered. You know, and we're starting off this way. They're getting stronger.
And they have a chance to swim.
That's what I'm talking about.
In 2022, with California facing prolonged drought, hatchery-raised winter-run salmon were facing imminent extinction. Federal and state agencies decided to act.
Is there gravel tree below it?
There's gravel down there. They'll stick eggs right here.
Yep.
They'll hatch.
They launched a long-discussed project that would take fertilized or eyed eggs from hatchery-raised winter-run salmon and introduce them into the cold waters of the McCloud, the river that the Winnemem Wintu people call Winnemem Waywaket. To implement their plan, the agencies were legally obligated to include the Winnemem Wintu tribe in the project planned for their river. So, in an historic initiative, federal and state agencies in the tribe became co-equal partners in the salmon restoration project.
The salmon have not been above the dam since the dam was installed. So today, salmon eggs are gonna be brought for the first time in almost 80 years. And it's important that we receive them in a good way. And the baby wanted to be here for that. My little eyed egg.
It's a beginning for many of you to make some good changes in the way that you look at your science and maybe the science that you didn't study yet. We're asking that the river receive these eggs. Poop is a eyed egg. And so we're asking that in the old time way that it continues to grow in that way. And we've put down that song so they have a fighting chance.
In a departure from standard fish culture practices, the first batch of hatchery eggs were placed in barrels beside the river, with river water running through them. But a few days after the eggs were introduced, the river became murky with sediment released by upstream McCloud Dam, owned by PG&E. Fearing the eggs would be smothered, fish scientists scrambled to move the eggs into heath trays, the standard hatchery equipment for egg incubation.
So the hatchery trays, they're the ones that they say they're the most successful because they have the most live fish from that tray. It seemed okay with 5,000 eggs, but then when the eggs started developing into alvins and fish, it seemed like it was like looking at a can of worms. You know, even though we're not fish biologists, we are from fish families, fish people. And our parents were the ones who were born on the river, that lived on the river until Shasta Dam was filled. They came from this river fishing. And so the knowledge passed on from them is what we're going on.
Oh.
The developed fry were then released into the Winnemem Waywaket, and 1,600 were caught in traps before reaching Shasta Lake Reservoir. They were then let go into the Sacramento River below Shasta Dam to continue their journey to the sea, and hopefully return in 3 years as adults.
May 1st.
On May 1st, 2023, the tribe and the agencies made their agreement official. The project will use hatchery-produced winter-run eggs until McCloud River salmon eggs can be brought home from New Zealand.
The Chinook that we're looking to bring back, you know, they're originally from this river. They're still wild. You know, we saw them in the wild, way up in the high country. You know, where the waters are like this. It's cold and they have a glacier melt.
In addition, planning will begin for a volitional fish passage to allow the salmon to swim naturally around Shasta Dam.
The future of salmon is us helping them come home. The reality is, in the state of California, for the most part, they haven't been able to get home. Bringing salmon home is part of salmon's future in California. So, Chief, thank you for your leadership in that regard.
For the egg introduction of 2023, Chief Sisk and her team developed an innovative design for an incubation tank that includes important elements of a salmon spawning bed.
It'll have spawning rocks in this egg tank so that the eggs get associated with the rocks.
And we developed it based on, you know, a more natural system.
I like how they have the chance to swim
any way they want to.
Yeah.
I see my little babies. Oh yeah, they're swimming. This is like what they would be in the river. They're swimming free, very gentle current in here, like as if they were in the nest. We believe that there's a connection between these eggs and the spawning rocks themselves. And the magnetism or the things that exchange between the rocks and the fish are part of what brings them that desire to get right back to this place. As alva, they still have the egg sac, and they're not such good swimmers. But once it's zipped up, they'll swim through this channel and into this pool, where there's different flows, so they're learning how to maneuver in the current. And they have the vegetation around them, so they're more apt to know how to maneuver the banks in the river system. Until they decide to go out this channel. And this channel goes into the side channel on the river, which is something that Winnemem's always built. And you would find the little fish in the side channels because they're protected there.
It's just really cool to see their behaviors and their ability to kind of use the whole water column when they're ready to.
And that's what they need. I mean, they have to learn how to do that.
And when they're in the trays, they don't have that vertical space, just right. Like you said. Yeah, it's true. They're practicing their swimming in the vertical.
It was like giving back the respect to those fish to do what they're supposed to do, develop their connection to these rocks and all of the plant life here. That's the reason they come back. It's like, how can they even come back if they're in plastic trays? Where are they coming back to? It's like, it doesn't even make sense to me. But that's the science.
You know, we lost some eggs.
We don't know exactly what happened, but it happened. And it affects all this place, all everything around.
I know in my heart when I heard that many eggs had died, I felt a lot of grief. So I just really asked for Creator's help.
And we've also found some parasites in some of the eggs. And so we need to discover what's going on with that and how that is coming in here.
Where'd you get a skin? This is an empty egg with worms in it.
Oh. Rachel. So how did they get inside the egg? Like they were alive in that one egg I videoed swimming.
So it was a pink egg with the parasite swimming in there. Could you actually see an embryo in there too?
We're still praying for our salmon in New Zealand. We have to make a path for them to return. Just to call on everything that we can to help open the doors, change people's minds, do the right thing here, and bring those fish from this river back to this river. And things are gonna change. It's a beginning. But we're not going to stop until there's a volitional passage and until we get our eggs back from New Zealand and the fish are swimming up here. It's the only way they can be recovered.
We have to come up with different solutions now.
Yeah.
And that's part of this partnership that, like you said earlier, this has never happened.
Yeah, it's never happened before. And so it is taking a different view rather than...
New ground for us.
Yeah. And on the side of fish.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We have to adjust things on their side, not convenient for us, you know. So it's going to be a struggle, but I think you guys can do it.